We're with Griffin Newman, Arthur from The Tick. How you doing?
I'm doing well. I'm doing well. Overwhelmed, but happy. Yeah.
Well, you get to play Arthur.
I do. Yeah.
The ultimate sidekick.
Yeah.
How's that feel, especially with a classic series?
Yeah, I mean, it's insane. Never starts feeling more real. You know, I got cast about a year and a half ago, and it's still, I feel a bit of disassociation whenever anyone says that out loud to me. It always feels like people are lying to me or like they're pranking me or something like that. But I definitely, you know, I felt like a sidekick most of my life. You know, I was the person kind of hanging on to the cool kid in high school or, you know, standing to the side of whatever the exciting thing was. So it's exciting to be able to, you know, play that on a larger scale. It's certainly a part I've been doing research for my entire life in one way or another.
But now you're the everyman hero.
Yeah, which is exciting. You know, I feel like if I was cast to play a hero, which I don't think anyone ever would, I wouldn't know how to do that. I wouldn't know how to be traditionally heroic or graceful or elegant or badass or any of that. But to be a normal guy in these normal, insane circumstances, these extraordinary situations, that I feel is exciting and that I hopefully can do.
I had a huge brain fart earlier with Valerie Curry. I was like, oh yeah, you're playing the love interest. She's like, no, I'm playing the sister. This isn't Game of Thrones, so.
Yeah, I mean, hopefully not. I had my friend watch the show, and he said, like, hey man, I love the pilot. My question is, are you and that girl gonna end up together? And I said, my sister? And he went, oh, maybe I need to watch it again. I don't know if I was paying close enough attention.
I'm just looking for the hate shares. How do you call yourself Fanboy Nation and you made that big of a faux pas?
Hey, look, at Comic-Con, we're all burnt out, you know? The San Diego heat gets to you. Yeah.
Listen, it's hot and humid. I'm fat and sweaty. These aren't the best combinations for anything.
I'm skinny and sweaty. I have the same problem, yeah.
So was there any scene that particularly stuck out that you just lost it and couldn't contain yourself with laughter that they had to reshoot 7 or 8 times?
I'm trying to think. There were a couple moments like that. Scott Spicer, who plays Overkill, has a moment that I cannot spoil that'll be coming up in the second half of the season that I think is such a pure distillation of his character, and he delivered it so well that I truly had to look down every single time, you know? And Peter has a line. He'll improvise things every take. And he's just got such a good sense of that character and such a good sense of his voice. I mean, I don't want to spoil any of the jokes, but it is, there are a couple of those moments, you know, where it's tough because I'm supposed to be nervous and panicked all the time. If I start laughing, it ruins the entire scene.
It's a pleasure meeting you.